Fabian, but I'm really talking, I'm talking to Fabian, but I'm going to talk to all of you guys. Is that cool? All right, so I just was witnessing conversation a little bit. And I know I've trained 50 plus reps to hit 10,000 plus. So I've trained, So I've trained probably 50 plus reps to hit 10 to $26,000 in fast start. And I've probably trained 50 plus people to have 10,000 to $30,000 pushes, right? So all in all, I've probably trained 100 people that have sold over 10,000 bucks in a push period, right? I don't say that to impress you guys. I just say it to impress upon you, like, what I'm going to tell you about, like, I'm an expert on it, right? Would you say, Fabian, that, like, you're an expert on walking, right? If someone said, like, how do you, you know, if there was a two-year-old that walked up to you and could speak, like, intelligently and said, like, how do you actually do that thing? Like, how do you walk, right? Would you be like, dude, I'm an expert. Like, I know what I'm talking about. I've been doing this for a long time. I've seen people do it. I know what I'm talking, like, I am an expert on this one. So, like, you're going to say to the two-year-old, like, whatever you say about walking, you're wrong. Like, your thinking is wrong. Right? My thinking is right on this one. Alex, come on in. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So this is the, just grab a seat. This is the, just grab a seat, okay. Yeah, this is the paradigm that, so like, I'm looking at it from here, and you're looking at it from here. We're both looking at the same thing, all right? But neither way is necessarily wrong, but there's one that has experience and knowledge, and the other one doesn't. Okay, so if these 100 plus people have sold $10,000 to $30,000 in a push, and by the way, I've seen reps sell over that in a push within my division, okay? Do you think they're, like, genetically, like, how genetically the same are they to you?
Pretty close.
Pretty, yeah.
They're probably 99.9% the same, right? Sample kit, right? Pretty much the same, right? 100%, maybe 99.9%, maybe one or two of them had like one product, but you actually have products today that some of them didn't have at the time, right? Okay, customers, right? What would you guess? If you do 60 demos, right, Michael, you've done 50 demos in a push, you're gonna run into every sort of customer, right? You're gonna run into the super wealthy customer if you do 50 demos. And you're going to run into the one that you're like, you walk in and you're like, oh my God, I'm not going to sell these people like a peeler, right? On the 50 demos that you did in your 14,000 push, was there the customer that like, you were like, wow, this person's not going to be able to afford much, right? There's always the one that's like the worst, and there's always one, the one that's the best. So my point is like, even your customers, right, the people you're going to be doing demos for are 99.9% the same. So what's different, right? It's you. Right, so this is what's different, right, between these guys and where you're at right now. Because right now you're wondering whether you can do it, right? Right. So number one is your belief system, right? Notice how we, right? Okay. It's your belief system. Number two is your state, like your emotional state, and number three is your strategies. What if I told you every single rep that did this, I told them exactly what to do, they did exactly that, and that was their strategy. So if I give you the goods, right, so here's the scrolls, right, I'm going to actually hand them to you. This is what I told 100 plus people to do, and they did it. Now the ones that didn't follow the strategy, what do you think is going to happen? It's kind of like a three-legged stool, right? This is 3D, right? So let's say that's a stool, right? Okay, well, fortunately, I was a political science major, right? All right, but let's say that's a stool, right? If we take away one of these stools, what happens? It's going to fall, right? Same thing with this. So your belief system, if it's not in the right place, or your state, which we'll talk about in a second, or your strategies, right? That's going to just kill it automatically. Okay, all you guys right now, what I'd like you to do is I'd like you to sit in your most confident way. I just want you to sit like you're the most, like if I said, if I saw you in life and this is your most confident state. Okay, like you're gonna right now. I want you to sit like you've never been this confident in your life. Is this all right? So look at Alex. Okay, does he in from an Alex way? Does he look confident? Alex, drop the thing, right? Because if you've got that in your hand, you're not confident, right? Okay, sit super confident. It could be lean back. I don't care how it is. Okay, you don't look confident. I feel like my computer's like halfway right. Pull the chair up. Pull the chair up. Okay. Okay. Now I'm pissing him off, right? And then he's gonna like, you know. Okay. Well, you gotta grab another chair then. Okay. Right. Fabian, can you give him this chair?
Yeah.
All right. Right. So now Alex is moving his body right around. He's probably feeling a little more mad at me. He's like, all right, screw this guy. I don't care who he is. Right. Right. Sit. Are you an absolute certainty and confidence right now? Okay, how about you? Are you in absolute certainty and confidence? Okay, now I want you to sit like you're super, like, unmotivated, depressed, like you're not going to get good results. Notice how your body changed, right? Now I want you to be normal. So how you normally sit. Okay, so now you're sitting normal, and now sit absolute confidence. Did you notice your chest went up, right? Did you notice how everyone, like, straightened up? And that's a 2 millimeter difference, right? Would you guys agree that if you're confident, or if you believe that it's going to happen, it's going to make a positive impact? I'm not saying you're going to accomplish it, but it's going to have a positive impact on it. So this one, you need to control this one. And what did you just realize a minute ago? I said, sit normal. Go ahead and sit normal, you guys. Okay, sit depressed. Sit super confident. Here's what's crazy is that you know what the physiology is of you confident. You've got to do that, right? Don't you feel differently right now in the confidence, like in the confident posture? Don't you feel differently now than you did in the weak, you know, depressed, I don't get productive results? Yes? You control that. Does that make sense? You control that. And you can't, you've got to remind yourself, if you got to put it on your phone every morning at 7 a.m. when you wake up, or 6 o'clock when you wake up, like, be confident, or like, sit confident. Or every time you're about to get on the phone, I want you to sit confidently or stand confidently. So one of the reps I worked with, he would walk around, because he knew walking around, he felt confident doing that. So when you're phoning, you've got to be confident. Does that make sense? Second, he's even like when you're going on to a demo. So some people, like, they make their move. Like, I had one rep. He used to knock on the door and he would go, I will sell, you will buy. And that just gave him confidence. Okay, like it was his ritual, right? There's a lot of basketball players. There's one guy, his name is Steve Alford. He played at Indiana University, had like one of the best free throw shooting percentages of all time. He would dribble the ball, and while he would dribble off the ball, he would actually reach down and wipe the sweat off of his hands onto his socks. And then like that put him in state. He would twirl the ball once in his hand, and then boom, he would go right here. And that put him in state. Does that make sense? It put him in a place where he was going to be absolute confident. Absolute confident person. There's a guy's name is Jason Flynn. You guys mostly don't know who he is. But he used to run interviews. He used to get 60% plus shows the training. He used to like shadow box before his interviews to get him in like the right mental state. Does that make sense? Just remember this matters. On a daily basis, before demos, before you get on the phone, come on in. Okay, come on in.
Come on in, Rob.
It's okay, you're not late. Okay, the next one is your belief system. Okay, so right now you're like, I've never sold 10,000 plus. Great. Have you ever been married? Do you think you might be married? So does the past have anything to do with the future? Because at one point you couldn't talk, you couldn't walk, you couldn't add, you couldn't read, you couldn't tie a tie, you couldn't match clothing, right? But what happened? It was actually trial and error, right? Does everyone understand that? Like, could you read as well as you read today? No, and at one point in the learning process of reading, it was like, have you ever seen Dumb and Dumber, right? Okay, does that make sense? So your belief systems right now, I don't know what you're thinking right now about whether you can sell 10,000 plus or not, but shouldn't it give you confidence knowing that 100 plus people that I've worked with did it? Okay, and you've got Michael here, right? He puts his pants on one leg at a time. It's not like he's different than you, but you said you sold $8,000, you did 30 demos, you did 50 demos. That's the difference. It's not that he's like better, more talented, he's got better customers or anything like that. He did 20 more demos. Let me ask you a question. Had you done 20 more demos, would you have hit 10,000 bucks? And then you'd be thinking differently today, right? You'd say, I'm the type of person that hits 10K. So your belief system really matters. And you've got to be thinking about, what do I think about what a customer can buy, is willing to buy? What do I think about phoning? Do I think I'm good at phoning? Do I think I'm bad at phoning? And if you think you're bad at phoning, you shouldn't define it that way. Look at it as like, hey, I'm getting better at phoning, right? Or my average order size is getting better. But if it's not getting better, if you're not doing anything to get it better, once again, the definition of insanity is like doing the same thing over and over, expecting a different result. So if I like walk into the wall, I'm like, oh, what happened? Oh, why did it happen again? Oh, what's going on here? I don't understand. Like, why am I like, right? You have to change your approach, right? At the end of the day, you've got to change your strategy sometimes, right? So your strategy was, I'm just going to like work hard, right? It wasn't much of a strategy, but it was like, I'm going to throw stuff on the wall and see what fits. Here's what I'm going to tell you. This is my experience, once again. I'm not saying it's different anywhere else. I'm telling you this, though. You do 40 demos, okay? I'm going to tell you, it is 99% likely that you'll sell 10,000 plus, okay? But there's some other correlations to that. You've got to do some preparation before you do those 40 demos, okay? And what you need to prepare on is getting better quality leads, closing better, all right, and phoning better. And phoning doesn't really help the 40 demos, but it helps you get better quality demos. Okay, so there's some reps that I've worked with, like, and I'm not saying you should do this, but some reps, like if a customer like is like fighting them about a demo, they're just like, okay, forget it, I don't need to do them. They don't say this to the customer, but they're like, I don't want the demo. I only want demos with people that are open-minded, right? But that means they have to call sometimes twice as many people. Does that make sense? Okay, so here's the deal. Like, you've got to find a way to get better quality leads and better at closing. There are some people that have like $800 average order size in our company. And you might be like, how do they do that? Because their belief system is different and their state is different, right? They're not scared asking for the order, right? Remember when you first started out, were you scared asking for the order? Of course you were. That changed your state, right? And once you change your state, you're like this, right? You're like, oh yeah, probably, you know, this is not gonna work. Oh, I'm probably annoying them. And they're gonna be mad at me for asking, right? And once that changes your state, it changes your belief system, right? And then no matter what strategy you have, if you got the wrong belief system and you're in the wrong state, you're toast. Does that make sense? You're gonna have to do like 80 demos. But the strategy, once again, right now at this point, is this. I'm gonna give you the goods. This is exactly what these guys did. They showed up every day, somewhere between 7 and 8 a.m. every day, Monday through Friday, okay, for learning, right? So that's where we help them on leads and closing. But you can't miss a day. You miss a day, let's say it's a 14-day push, right? I don't know what 1/14th is. I know what 1/12th is. I think it's like 8%. Okay, so this is probably like what? 6%. Okay, so the first day that you miss a meeting like this, you have 6% less information than everyone else does. Okay? The second thing they did is they had a lot of names and numbers before they showed up. A lot is a relative term. You've got to push yourself. So I'm going to ask you a question. If I gave you guys $2,000, I don't have $2,000 on me. I'm going to see what I have, and this might make it a little bit more real for you. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So here's 400 and a bunch of 20s. Let's say it's 500 bucks, right? So if I said to you, I'm going to hand this to you, Fabian, okay, by tomorrow, at 7 a.m., but you have to have 200 names and numbers. You don't have 200 names and numbers, you don't get the 500. Okay? How many names do you think Fabian's going to have tomorrow morning, 7 a.m.?
120.
He's going to have at least 200, right? Okay? Could you get 200 names between now and today, tomorrow?
Yeah.
Could you get 200 names?
Yeah.
Could you get 200 names? Could you get 200 names? Could you get 200? Okay, so I'm not going to give you $500, right? I lied. But Vector's going to give you way more than that. Have you thought about that? Right, because I'm going to use Fabian in this example, right? Fabian, how much, what percent are you at right now?
45%.
So you're going to get to 50%, right? So we'll just, to make the math easier, we're going to say you're at 40%. And just know that it's beyond that. Okay, you sell 40% and you sell $10,000, at 40%, you make $4,000. So the company's not going to give you $500. They're going to give you almost 10 times that amount. So they're going to give you $500 eight times. Okay? You've never seen $500 in cash or have you before? Okay. For work that you did. Awesome. All right. How about everyone else in the room? Okay. You've never seen that, right?
Oh, no, I have.
Okay, you have. Okay, awesome. That's good. Okay. Has it ever been your own?
Yes.
Okay, awesome. Okay, good. Have you ever seen eight times that?
Yes.
Okay. Personally?
Yes.
Awesome. What did that feel like?
It's pretty sweet.
It's pretty sweet, right? Was it your own?
Yes.
That's awesome. Okay. Fabian, I'm going to tell you what. Cutco is going to pay you this amount, right? They're going to write you a check for that amount. Do you think having 200 names is probably going to make it more likely for you to be there? Yes. So you got to think like, okay, 200 names divided by $4,000, that's like $20 a name. For every name you can think of, that's $20. Right? What's that? Yeah, you're going to learn a lot more, right? So here's the deal. Okay? So why were you willing to come up with 200 names when I flashed $500 in front of you? And you probably wouldn't know before that, right? If I had asked you before that, you guys, if I had said, hey, Fabian, how many names can you come up with between today and tomorrow? What number, and again, this is a hypothetical, what number would you have guessed he would have said?
20.
You'd have been like, I don't know, maybe 20. What if I said, what if you push yourself? He'd have been like, maybe 50, right? But I had $500 in front of you, right? I went like this, and what were you thinking?
200 names.
What were you thinking of? Like, what can I do with that money, right? Wouldn't that be cool? So you got to just figure out why you're working. So let me ask you guys, why do you want to sell 10,000 plus in a push period? Okay, so one reason is you go to Cabo. And Cabo, it's four letters, and you guys might be like, Cabo, I don't know, that sounds kind of cool. Let me just tell you that Cabo, I've traveled around the world many times. I've been many places multiple times. Cabo is my favorite destination spot for a vacation. Okay, for like a sunny vacation, right? Not like a historical landmarks like seeing Europe vacation, but for just chilling out, it's my favorite. Okay, this is an all-inclusive hotel, which means you don't pay a dime for anything the second you walk out of the hotel. Whatever you want, whenever you want it, you pay for nothing. So it's not just Cabo, it's an experience that you might not ever have. So I'll ask you a question, you know, Fabian. How often does your mom and dad get invited to a trip like this? All expense paid, you don't pay a freaking dime for it. Do they get invited to trips like that all the time in their job?
No.
No. So that's another one. Here's another one. Because you get an experience that most people in America will never get, right? So we'll say like an experience, right? So we'll, an, right? Why else would you want to sell 10,000?
Branch.
Okay, because it'll help your, you know, branch manager startup fund. Okay? If you're like, I don't know if I want a branch, just know that you actually want a branch. You just don't know yet you want a branch. Does that make sense? Okay, once you learn what branching is all about, you'll be like, yeah, I should branch. Okay? So it would actually help your branch start. Even if you're like, well, I'm not branching this year. Great, it'll help it 2 years from now. Okay, why else would you want to do this?
Personal income.
Okay, so income to do what? You don't make money just to make money, right? You don't just like, you know, roll around naked in your money, do you? Okay, what do you do with money? So what would you, I'm going to use Fabian, what would you, if you had $4,000, right, plus, what are some things that you would buy?
Go to an NBA game.
Okay, so you go to an NBA game. What game?
Jazz Miami.
Okay, Jazz Miami, right? Would you go by yourself?
No.
That would be no fun, right? So who would you take?
Friends.
Friend, how many?
Three or four.
Okay, three or four friends. You'd stay in a hotel, right? Now is it becoming a little bit more like exciting, right? It's not like, oh, I got to come up with 200 names, right? Like showing up at 7 a.m., it's like no big deal. If James told you, you got to show up every day here to clean the office every day for the next 4 weeks, but then he's going to give you a trip to Cabo and like jazz tickets and $4,000. Not and $4,000, but with that $4,000, you could go to the jazz game. Would you do that?
Yeah.
What if you said you had to stay here from 7 to 10 p.m., 7 a.m. to 10 p.m. every night? You do it, right? What else? Why else? How else do you benefit? Okay, right now you would do the impossible, right? Because right now you're wondering whether you can do it. All of you, I don't care who you are. Even Michael's like, I don't know if I can do it. I did it last year. I really believe I can do it, but I don't know, maybe last year was a fluke. I don't care who you are, no matter what experience you have, you might have actually, like, you might think, you just, everyone thinks crazy thoughts, right? Okay? Why else, how else do you benefit?
The experience from that.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. You're going to fail a bunch. You're going to learn a lot about failure. And as a result, you learn a lot about what? Success, right? What else, Michael?
I like to be the example. I like to be number one.
Okay. You're going to become a leader. You're going to develop your leadership skills. You're going to get a heck of a lot of recognition, right? You're going to develop more discipline, right? Gee, I wonder if everyone needs a little bit more discipline in life, right? What else? You're going to think bigger, right? This could actually, and by the way, because you do all this, you know, have your standards ever risen because someone in your family raised their standard? So you actually might raise the standard of everyone that you know. Just by this one simple thing, right? Because you tell your parents or your friends, I want to sell $10,000 worth of knives to people in their home. What do they say? You're crazy. They tell you you can't do it. My mom, 20 years ago, told me you can't make money selling knives. I was right. She was wrong. I took her to Spain. I took her and my dad to Spain, Italy, and Argentina on company trips. These were three places I decided to take them, right? She was wrong. I was right. It's a great feeling, by the way. Okay? What else? You prove others wrong, right? What else? What if I told you this is going to be the springboard to the rest of your life? To, like, the new version of you. Like, not the wimpy version of you who was, like, kind of, like, unmotivated and all that. It's the ass-kicker, like, boom, you pull off your shirt, there's an S under your chest. What if I told you that after 10 days of that, or after 14 days of that, that's who you would be the rest of your life? Because at some point, by the way, you're going to want to be that person, right?
Yeah.
Some point, you're going to want to be that person. When's the best time to start being that person if you want to be that person at some point?
Yeah.
Today. Right? Because if you're like, if you start pushing yourself now, you're going to be a better version, right? Because you're thinking like this. Oh, my life's going to go like this, right? So you might as well make it like this instead, right?
Yeah.
So you might as well start pushing it now. And you won't be that person unless you push yourself, grow in discipline, right? Grow in your ability to overcome failure, right? Become more of a leader. Your communication skills will develop, right? Like, do you need me to keep listing out reasons why? Like, I can eliminate this one now, right? I can say, you're not going to make any money. If you can get all of this in 14 days somewhere else, if one of your friends said, I have a place where you can get all of this in 14 days, from January 2nd to whatever the push is. What if they told you, I have a place for you to do this? We're going to climb Mount Everest, right? What if James said, you know what? I called your parents. We're going to fly to Mount Everest. And you're going to summit Mount Everest. You'd be like, what, James? No, we okayed it with your parents. We're leaving right now after this meeting. Right? You would learn all that stuff, right? Summiting Mount Everest. People die climbing that mountain. It's 29,000 feet. Right? What if James told you, that's what we're doing. We're actually not pushing anymore. Vector shut down for 2 weeks, and we're flying to Mount Everest. Wouldn't you be nervous and excited? Wouldn't you walk away differently as a human? Isn't that who you want to be? So, like, screw the money. Right? The money is just like gravy on top. Look at all of this that you stand to benefit. What does it really take? It takes you writing down a bunch of names, which you would have done for one-eighth of the price, and you showing up every day, and us being able to teach you stuff. How much has James taught you about what he knows about selling Cutco, you guys, at this point? Out of 100% of what he knows, he's probably taught you, I'm guessing, 5% of what he knows. Even you, Michael. Maybe Michael's at like 7%. How long have you been with Vector?
8.5 years.
8.5 years. Do you think he can cram everything he knows of 8.5 years in like the little time frame that you guys have worked with him? That's why you show up to that meeting every day. And if you every day you show up, you develop discipline, right? Because you're not going to want to show up, right? In January, it's freaking dark still at 6 a.m. Like, you're going to show up, it's dark, you're going to get home, and it'll be dark again. Right? You know, but unlike, let's say, and I'm not saying, and I'm not ripping on working in a factory, but there are people that will wake up, go to a factory, work there, never see the daylight. And they'll leave, and it's still dark outside. You guys will be like in Mrs. Jones's, like, heated home, right? You're like, you guys have this, like, we live in Chicago, like, you look outside, you don't see anything. Here, it's like, you look outside, like, you see these beautiful mountains and stuff, right? You have this sit on a comfortable chair all day, like, oh, it's so hard at the job that you guys have, right? Oh, my God, James is such a mean person. He's helping you make this and get all this by showing up every day. You think James wants to show up every day at 7 a.m. or whatever? No way. Right? But why does he do it? It's because he's willing. He knows this is how you're going to benefit. Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. So just remind yourself, is it worth it? So now, can you do it, Fabian?
Yeah.
For sure, right? Because right now, it's like, of course I can, because like, I'm going to gain so much. So you're willing to do, what if I told you you had to do 100 appointments in that time frame? Would you be willing to do that?
Yes.
It's like, whatever it takes, James, I'm willing to do that. Does that make sense? All right.